Sushant Singh Rajput, a self-made actor on the peak of his career and success. At least, that's what was presented to us, and that's what we believed. His movies were doing so good, and he was earning so much, that made us feel, obviously, he is happy. Why wouldn't he? He is successful now, and he is rich. Then suddenly a news comes of his suicide, with no suicide letter, and we are left in the darkness of the actual reason behind his suicide. But being a human being, we love to assume. Suddenly, I saw a wave of people started talking, giving their opinions, and started guessing the reason behind his suicide. A group of people started blaming established actors, directors, and producers, and a movement of boycotting their upcoming films started. I really want you to ask yourself one simple question. Can we really find the exact reason behind his suicide? If yes, then please tell me how. If no, then why are we guessing things according to our own beliefs? Bob Marley once said, "Road of life is rocky, and you may stumble too. So while you talk about me, someone is judging you." Understand this loop. When we judge others, don't forget that we are being judged too. It happens all the time. Stop for a moment, think before you speak, and try practicing not to judge. Here, self-control plays a major role. Hence, in my previous video, I have talked extensively about self-control and how to be a conscious communicator. If you haven't checked that video, please check it. It's worth your time. I will provide you the link in the description box below. Being judgmental about anything is very easy. As a human being, we keep judging others. And by others, I mean literally everyone. Let me tell you a short story to understand this. A father and a son was in a train riding to their destination, and the son was staring out the window with his amazed eyes, glancing at each and everything. He called his dad in a loud and excited voice and said to him, "Look, Dad, look, look, there's trees." There was a couple sitting next to them and stared at the boy with irritated eyes for his strange behavior. Few minutes passed, he again called his dad with same enthusiasm and said to him, "Look, Dad, look, clouds are running with us." But this time the couple really got irritated and just yelled at the father, asking him why don't he consult a psychologist for his son, because according to them, something was really not fine with his child. The dad smiled with his eyes full of tears and replied that they are just returning from the hospital after his son's eye operation, who was blind since birth, and that's the reason of his son's excitement, as he is actually seeing all these things for the first time. Often we think we know what everyone is going through, but the truth is we have no idea. If you're trying to pull someone down, you have to realize that you are already below them. Judgment is our ability to form an opinion objectively or authoritatively about something or someone. Sometimes people themselves, being in a bad phase of their life, try to judge others by putting themselves down just to make themselves feel good. But maximum times, they judge others accidentally, without even knowing. And that's what is happening in the suicide case of actor Sushant Singh Rajput and the story I presented about a dad and a son. Actually, there are three reasons why we judge others. Number one, we may not know the person very well. Number two, that person invades or threatens how we perceive ourselves. Number three, you cannot identify with their beliefs or behaviors. Judging someone is just unfair and unwise. You need to understand that our words and actions have impact on others. There are so many people today dealing with so much that our tiniest action can become a huge trigger in their personal life. Remember, we are extremely good lawyers of our own mistakes, but even better judges of others' mistakes. Judging others doesn't define who they are, it defines who you are.